The Ayala Group has said the COVID-19 pandemic has renewed its commitment to invest in healthcare. We're still with AC Health President and CEO Paolo Borromeo to tell us more about the group's plan. What other ways are you planning to grow?
First and foremost is what we call organic expansion, April. No? So after we've stabilized things and gotten through this crisis, we look at investing in more clinics, possibly more capacity for our hospitals, look for new hospitals as well. And then, of course, grow our what we call our greenfield businesses. And then beyond that, we continue to, of course, keep an eye out for what we call inorganic opportunities. So any M&A possibilities, we keep an eye out for.
So what are you looking for in terms of potential M&A targets?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. I think what's important is there's a strategic fit to what we're trying to build. So whether it's in the pharmacy space or in the clinical space or the hospital space, there is some strategic value and fit to the ecosystem of assets and the network of assets that we're building. Because we're not doing these things in isolation. All of these are mutually beneficial. So we invest in pharmacies because the pharmacies help our clinics and our hospitals with their medication requirements, right? We would look at adjacent opportunities that would fit into that system. So possibly other hospital groups, possibly other clinic groups, possibly other pharmacy groups. But of course, beyond the strategic fit, there's also the cultural fit, April. So it's also important that we believe that we would partner with institutions that share our vision, not for integrated or affordable healthcare for all Filipinos, and aspire to achieve the same things that we want to achieve, which is provide more affordable quality healthcare to millions of Filipinos.
So going forward, like, is funding actually a concern for your growth? Or, has healthcare become of greater priority to the AC Group?
No, very much so. I think it's one of the key pillars that we are committing to for the future. It's our newest group, April, as you know, so it's still fairly small compared to other businesses that we have. But the impact is so enormous. And so I think we realize that. And the need from a nation building perspective is just huge. No? So I think there's really a lot that we can do. To date, we've allocated about 12 billion pesos to healthcare, April. And I believe we would put more capital to work, no? As opportunities arise in healthcare. Capital is less of an issue. I think as a group, we've handled our balance sheet very well over the last few years. As you know, we're a very conservative group, April. So proud to say that we have a strong balance sheet and where we believe we can deploy capital and put it to work, we have the capacity to do so, of course, in a very cautious manner. No? But capital-wise, we've self-funded now with equity from Ayala Corp, all our needs with AC Health. But who knows, in the future, we may look at outside sources of funding to help augment capital that we put in. We're always looking, at the future, and there may be opportunities for outside investors and strategic partners at the AC Health level. But that we'll take that over time.
What about bringing some of your subsidiaries to public, like through an IPO? Are there any plans?
We don't know. At this stage, it's too early to tell. I think it's always a nice moonshot, right, and aspiration to get a subsidiary large enough, sizable enough to be listed. But we'll take that over time. I think for us, April, our focus is to, of course, execute on all of those milestones that I mentioned earlier. No? We have a fantastic platform, the HealthWay clinics, our cancer hospital, QualiMed hospitals, and then our Health Now digital health platform, that's starting to create a unique ecosystem, which I think no one else really has. And for us, the challenge is to tie all of these together, stabilize them, make sure that we weather the crisis, and then eventually expand and grow the ecosystem further, whether organically or inorganically. Going public is a function of timing, of need, of relevance, and we'll take those factors into consideration.
So do you think the pandemic will actually accelerate the consolidation process?
I think so. No, the crisis creates so many challenges for different players and different institutions. I think it creates unique opportunities for consolidation, for strategic partnerships. But of course, like you said, it has to be the right mix and the right fit of parties. But you know, I think it will. I think you will see the system go through significant disruption. I think that's fair to say. Healthcare, in as much as it's front and center now with the crisis, as a sector, as an industry, it will go through massive disruption. But there's a huge potential for capital investment, both in the private sector and the public sector. And there are unique opportunities to create meaningful scale and impact in the industry.
So when you're looking for acquisition targets, are you open to acquiring, say, hospitals that are not profitable? Or you want to wait for a hospital or, say, a clinic to be profitable first before you go in?
Well, ideally, there is evidence of profit, April, and then evidence of growth as well. And then most importantly, evidence of fit. So, of course, we would look at the hospital that's already located in an area where we have a hospital. But I think you would want to see evidence of financial sustainability and growth potential.
For my last question, I just like to ask you how AC Health is positioned to capitalize on the growth opportunities facing the Philippine healthcare industry.
Well, first of all, as I mentioned, what we're building is an integrated network, and our belief is the country, the sector needs integrated networks. In fact, that's the very vision of universal healthcare, right? You know, everything is really connected in one way or another so that you're properly treating people throughout the continuum here. And we have a very unique business model because we have a chain of clinics, chain of hospitals, surrounded by a chain of pharmacies and drugstores, and complemented by a digital health platform. And I think that by itself is such a unique advantage and capability that we have that we feel we can use to our advantage and, you know, to weather the storm. And most importantly, to provide better healthcare to more Filipinos. We are able to launch widespread clinical programs. So for instance, cancer screening programs that we plan to do, heart cardiology screening programs that we intend to do, mental health programs that we plan to do. And because of our network, we're able to do that in as a broad-reaching and widespread way as possible. Look forward to continuing to help our countrymen and our communities throughout this crisis and beyond this crisis.
Okay, on that note, thank you very much, Paolo, and good luck to AC Health.